was going on between 1965 and 1970. We were right there in the middle of it. So I said, oh yeah, I can do it. So the next thing I know, I'm going to practice four times a week, and Lindsay lives right down the street from me in Menlo Park. And so within 3 weeks, 4 weeks, we were actually doing shows and opening for really big acts, like Jimi Hendrix, 75,000 people. Janis Joplin, 30,000 people at Stanford University. Right before the movie Woodstock came out, Santana in Monterey, Carmel. And we were stuck in Lodi with Creedence Clearwater, and we were really stuck there because our car broke. So that's not the half of it. I mean, we opened for everybody. So we made really good money, and I'd heard this rumor that there was this amazing store up in downtown San Francisco where you could buy like amazing clothes, and that's where the rock and roll women that had any money and that were kind of famous went to buy their clothes. So I said, well, I'm going. So I got my little cranberry convertible, 5-speed Spider Monza, and zipped up there to San Francisco and found the store, went in. It was a tiny store. It was fantastic, but it was tiny. Had a beautiful hand-painted floor. And I'm standing there like, I can't afford anything here. I just know. I didn't even really bother to look at the price tags. So, but I'm realizing that I'm standing probably in the same place that Janis Joplin stands, or Grace Slick stands, or a myriad of other very famous women have stood. And I'm going, so I'm not buying clothes, but I'm sure as hell standing in the place where the great women have stood. So I had a definite premonition at that moment where I really felt, I felt what was coming. It's like I saw the future, and I'm not kidding. I felt it, and I turned around and walked out of that store a different person. The store was called the Velvet Underground. So it really touched me and made an imprint on me. And the reason I'm telling you this story is because I always like to remind people that if you have a dream, don't let anybody take your dream away from you. And don't let people say, even in this high-tech world, that you can't do what you want to do, because you can. You just have to really want to do it and fight for it and tell people, get out of your way so that you can make your life great. Because otherwise, your life's going to suck. And you don't want it to, because you don't have to. You can have everything you're supposed to. Reach out there and get it. So I'm back to the Velvet Underground, back to the floor that I loved, to a room with some lace and some paper flowers, back to the Gypsy that I